Good evening and welcome once again to Clio Cup Action, hosted by NXTGEN, brought to you in association with Ollie Pidgley Racing. Round 10 of the Clio Cup brings us to Germany, to Oschersleben. I think that's how it's pronounced anyway. So we're into the qualifying session. Just over 5 minutes has been completed. At the moment we've got Cam 123 Diz on provisional pole. So let's jump to him and see how he's getting on. So we've got Cam, FRT Holman just behind him there as well. Scooby, RS Jim down in 10th at the moment there. Sure, we'll see him move up the field as the qualifying session progresses. But Cam at the moment, do what needs to, be where he needs to be. Ideally, he needs to have a much better result than Jim tonight to claw some of the deficit that is between them. So if you are watching on YouTube, say hello, let us know who you're rooting for tonight. So EDU Pro Driver might be another one to watch, showing his potential during the last few weeks. RS Jim, will he improve now? Yeah, it goes up to fifth there, so massive jump up, five places for the young lad there. FLT Hillman, he has missed a couple of rounds due to real life activities, so he has unfortunately lost, he's out the running to finish top, but showed great potential on the short circuit tonight for Oschersleben as well, so we'll see plenty of laps in, plenty of close action with the track being that small as well. So Cam in his usual yellow and black livery there as well. Oh, almost getting sideways there. A little bit of a lock up from him. So Purple Twig 69, newcomer to the league tonight, filling in. So he's already making impressions there as well, running well in third. So Jim now pushed down to sixth as well. Is he going to improve? What's the line? No, he stays down in six. So this is definitely, you know, this is playing out as Cam wants it to at the moment. He needs to have as many gaps in there. I think that's Cam there as well, almost getting sidewards. Tires screeching across the track. So Scooby down in seventh in the pits at the moment. Gonzi down in eighth. So a couple of the boys that are normally out in front, sort of way down the table compared to where they normally are at the moment as well. You know, still plenty of time left, still over 20 minutes left, so I'm sure we'll see some changes. But strange to see those guys down in the places that they are. So Gonzi's just moved up to sixth there as well. He pushed Jim down to seventh. So Jim will definitely be pushing hard. We'll go on board with Jim now. Oh, he was a little bit of the, as much of the outrun of the track as he can. Comes down the home straight. So he's actually gone down to seventh there. I think it's got into fifth there. Such a small track this. It's literally once you finish your lap, you're pretty much, I mean, at this point here, you know, almost at the end and onto another one. So very, very short circuit. So really no room for error whatsoever in this qualifying session on the laps. It's Neckerman going to improve again. Now stays in fifth. So Cam almost half a second out in front at the moment. First place. So obviously been practicing well. So just on board with Cam now. Yeah, that's the good thing. You can push really hard in this qualifying session. Because if you make a mistake, you know, it doesn't take long to get another lap put through. And there is Jim just behind Cam. So is Cam going to better his lap? Just extend his lead a little bit. Is Jim not able to make good progress as we normally see from him at the moment? Takes a very wide line into that corner. Oh, and he goes off the track there, so not sure if he's struggling tonight. So Gonzi coming back out onto the track. We see Blue Gobi is now taking second place. So just pushed in front of FRT Holtman with his time there. Everyone out on track, trying, apart from Glazing, pushing as hard as these little Clios can go. Cam just stay out on track. If you wanted to extend his lead as much as he can. I think that's Oldie that was getting some sideways action in the car. It was. He's pushing that little clear as much as he can. Lovely view. Oh, a bit of contact there. Looked like. So it was Cam and Holtman coming together there in the qualifying session. Neither of them will want that. Especially Holtman. Oh, Holtman's. Oh, we just had someone that's dropped out. No. Thought Holtman had changed position there, but no, he's still third. So Holtman definitely doesn't want to have any more incidents like that. He needs a clean run out on track. Hopefully won't get into any traffic. Looks pretty clear run in front of him. So just get a nice run. Oh, seems to be struggling that corner there. A little bit of a lock up. Oh, Cam almost getting on two wheels there, coming through that corner. So we'll stay with Holtman at the moment, see if he can improve. And looking at Cam, it looks like he's the one that's pushing the most at the moment. Don't think he's improved on his time just yet. You can see Cam there in the yellow and black Clio just in front of Holtman. You can see there Cam, he's really pushing that little Clio as much as he can. He's not giving up that provisional pole without a fight tonight. Well, he is breaking, he's letting Holtman go in front. So, will we see Holtman now move up from third? Now he improves on his time though, he does get a better lap, but not enough to push Blue Gobi or Cam from their spot at the moment. Breaking hard into the first and second corner. That corner may cause some problems. Hopman's got his lights blaring now. But yeah, that corner one. Hopefully will be incident free. But we know what these Clio Cup races can be like, everyone. Wants the points. Might play into the likes of RSGS if there is an incident, you know, with the front few going into that first corner in the race. Oh, Hartman going into the dirt there. Cam following him. But may play into them if they can stay back. If there's an incident at the front, they might be able to find a way through. Of course, we'll await the race and see what happens. Is Hartman going to improve now? He doesn't. It improves on his time again, so he's chipping away ever so slightly, but it's not enough at the moment. Oh, Scooby and RS Jim leaving the pits there. Now starting their attack. Oh, someone coming out the pit. Oh, looks like. Luckily, goes to the car though, but. Someone coming out the pits. Looks like the traffic go. Looks like Cam's slowing to let him go through as well. Now he's let Cam go through. Could have been treacherous. Oh, Scooby. Always get the back end out there. That was a lovely little shot. Jim is moving out the way. It's at the front through. You can see how fast Cam is pushing it. Nikita Meyer. Probably have got the surname out. Hello. Thanks for tuning in. So we've got 13, just over 13 minutes left to qualify. And then there's a 5-minute warm-up session. And then it's half an hour of racing, so stay tuned, stick with us. Some guaranteed race, close racing tonight. So Cam's still not improving on his time, but no one really looking like they're going to do any damage at the moment. Blue Gooby Gobi in second, but still almost half a second away from the top spot time at the moment. So Purple Twig 69, as I mentioned, newcomer to the league this evening. So he's making good impressions, racing out in fourth at the moment. You know, certainly showing a lot of the more experienced Clio Cup races what can be done. Nice livery choice on that clear. I've not noticed that one before. Nice. Oh, Hotman has now taken second place. And has closed that gap to Cam. There's nothing in it now between him and Cam. Literally just a heartbeat between them. See the track there, just how busy it is in certain parts with traffic will make it difficult for people to get the time that they need. John, sorry, sorry to say that you're not racing tonight, mate. You know, hopefully you're feeling better soon, but enjoy the racing. Stick with us for all the action. See Hotman, he's pushing it. He can sense that he can take that first place now. So we'll stick with him as he comes to the straight last corner. Is he going to be able to take the top spot? He doesn't, stays in second. Cheers, John. So Cam's in the pits, he'll obviously be watching this. Probably feels that there's not a lot else that he can do in terms of getting his time down. So all he can do is just sit and pray that Holtman just is not going to be able to take the pole off him. Blue Gobi, yeah, he's managed to, on his last lap, improve as well. Unfortunately not on this one. Again, he's not too far off now. So a lot of people in the 112 bracket at the moment. So it's just because it's such a small track. Just the littlest error. You know, that millisecond of not getting the power down as the person in front. And, you know, you're just going to miss out. Out of time. Yeah, Nathan. Sorry about that. Pull me up. Yeah, it's so close at the moment. Pretty much between the you know, first. Let's just see what the last place time is. 1:13.4, 1:12. So yes, yeah, there's not really anything in it throughout the whole field. Oh, Cam almost get it there, managed to keep it. This will be his out lap. Weaving to get some heat in the tyres. And driving across the grass is definitely not going to get heat in the tyres. Well, all that hard work, unfortunately, he will lose it. I think that's EDU, who's for some reason seems to be on track. He's letting the field go. Yeah, turn one I did mention just before. Hopefully we won't see any incident, but I've raced on this track enough times to you know, and because it is a short track as well, you know, it's going to be more than just lap one where there's going to be a lot of traffic heading for that corner at the same time. Luckily these corners are quite small, so you can get a, you know, 2-3 wide going in, but if everyone goes to the same line in that corner, tyres are definitely going to be shed. So Holtman still not able to close the gap anymore. He's still 1:12.2. Anyone else who's had the best lap? So Gonzi, he's pushing just outside. Is he going to improve on this one? So no, stays six. So we're pretty much approaching, you know, just over 5 minutes left to go in the qualifying session now. So now this is it now. I mean, plenty of time to get more laps. Gonzi is going into the pit. Maybe feels that's all he can do. Now coming pushing hard here. Looking like he might be able to upset a few of the guys at the top. So he gets on with this lap. As he approaches the finish line. Nope, stays where he is in fifth. So stay with Holtman as he tries and tries. Oh, leaning so hard on that left suspension as he throws it around the corner. Bounces across the curbs. I have a feeling that's the... He's just pushing maybe a bit too hard in that section. That's where he might be losing the little bit of time that he needs to get that first place. Well, that provisional pole from Cam. Just with him using the dirt, is going to be slowing him down. I think if he can get that section nailed, I think we could see him take first spot. So we'll stick with him on this lap. He has got a bit of traffic in front now to contend with. So John Green saying that Cam got this. Nice work there by, who was it, Purple Twig, allowed Cam, Holtman, just to go out in front. So awesome driving there. So Holtman, you see him here as his car leans heavily on the left suspension. He does well though. Takes that corner nicely. So here it is. This is where Holtman really needs to try and does much better on this one. So are we going to see him take provisional pole now? I think we might see him improve on his lap time if he doesn't take it. Gets a good exit from the last corner. No, so that last lap was 12.7. So just going to try and work out where he can make some time. So I mean, we saw Cam on two wheels on that part before, so FB Cam's got this track sussed more than anyone tonight. Still not improved on his time though. So you see him taking quite a tight line into that corner. Holtman. So again, goes into a bit of the dirt on there. I mean, you can see that he is definitely pushing it. He definitely wants this provisional pole. So he's not improving. Where's Jim? Jim's still down in seventh. He moves up to fifth though. So I mean, it literally is just getting that split second final wake up. Oh, Jim, not getting the best line into the corner one there. Lovely little camera shot that was, Jim and Gonzi. Yeah, not good on tyres. I mean, tyre wear is off. Obviously, the heat could be an issue, but I'd have thought that maybe on a track like this, being the kind of turns and how long it is, might be okay to keep heat in the tyres. It's definitely going to be interesting qualifying. Oh, tyre wear is on. Ah, okay. I thought tyre wear was off. Ah, so that definitely could. That's definitely going to play a factor then, so. I think it could be one of them where. Maybe it's best just to hold off. Don't push too hard. Yeah, his track is definitely going to be a tyre killer then. So FLT Hotman has got his best lap there. It's, feels that it's all he can do though. He's in the pits. Okay, he's still pushing. Purple Twig. So Jim's just got enough. Can he pull something out of the bag? Right at the end, we have seen Cam do it to Jim in previous rounds. So no, I don't think Jim is going to have enough time to get this round. I think he's just a couple of seconds out. The time. We'll stay with him and see if he can improve. But I think this is going to be Cam's. Chris Nickel. Yeah, there's always room in the group that we've got, including this, three rounds left. So after this week, there's two rounds. Then we take a break, and then our next season, so season 9, starts the week commencing the 31st of July. But yeah, come along. We've got, because our Fazia set of course has got private lobbies, so it's not just Clio Cups that we run. It's pretty much any class of racing that you can think of. We've got it going on, races every night. So yeah, just find us on Facebook, NXTGEN Racing League's community. Just request to join. We'll keep a lookout for your name. You might get a message from myself or one of the other admin when you do request to join. But yeah, come along and join in the fun, mate. So there is your poll. Well done to Cam. Did well to hold that off. Holtman unfortunately just couldn't get it, but I mean, that's just qualifying. Race is going to be a completely different story. So we've just got a 5 minute warm up just to go now. So is anyone gonna use this for track time? So EDU going out on track. Okay, not a problem, mate. We've got a website as well. If you go to www.nextgenracingleague.co.uk, you can sign up through there. Add me on if you're on PlayStation as well. Just send me a friend request. Robot Dancing Dad. And I'll send you more info through that as well. But if you can, definitely helps having a Facebook account just to keep up with all the goings on in NXTGEN. Even if you just set one up for the group. So you can keep up to date with all the goings on. Start dates for new season, leagues, etc, etc. So not many people using the time out on track. I've never noticed that library on that Clio Cup car before. Never noticed that one. I quite like that one as well. So EDU stopping on the home straight. Seems to be a thing that he does. I'm not sure why. Nope, he's starting again. Must be just waving to the crowd. Stopping for picture opportunities. I don't know why he does it. So now coming in is pink and white angry ant livery. An easy one to spot on the track. Chris, if you've just sent me a request there, mate, I've just got it. I'll accept it at the end of the race, mate. So EDU and Gonzi's stuck there. Nice little camera shot. Gonzi's now on the move from the pit lane. So, of course, I mean, it doesn't matter what people do in this session. This is literally just to get some extra practice time on the track. And Subtone chooses to go around the track backwards. Little spectacle for the viewers here. I think he's attempting to do a lap backwards. Ah, he's not able to hold it there. He's going to try and get the car going. So is he going to be able to do a lap? He's taking the corners well, really. Considering he is driving in the reverse gear. Oh, nice little shot in the distance there of a little Clio sliding around the corner. So Subtone, please. Nice little spectacle for the 5 minute warm up here. Might try and make this a regular thing. You can get round a lap backwards in the car. So Purple Twig 69 taking claim rights at the moment in the warm-up session. The best lap. Obviously no extra points or anything awarded for that. Subtone still getting this car around backwards. Ah, he loses it there. Unlucky. That definitely took some doing to get the car out here backwards, though. There's EZU, just the distance. Turning into a lawnmower. If you are watching, so we've obviously got Cam. It's pole. Yeah, definitely was some skill there. So, let us know in the comments who you think's gonna get it. So Calm, Holtman, lots and lots to choose from. Jim, Gonzi, EDU. No, there's no Amiga double dunk tonight. He's at Knockhill, watching the classic tourers. So let's wait until the lights go green. We're tied to the pits. Catch up with the action. Oh, so that's Neckelman. So there has been already chaos on the start. So we're with Jim at the moment, he's in fourth. Gets pushed out onto the dirt there. So okay, turn one has taken. Oh, there's absolute chaos throughout the field at the moment. So bunched up on this track. So Holtman has managed to get into first. Cam just behind him. Blue Gobi third, Gonzi fourth, Subtome and EDU in sixth. So Neckerman unfortunately got flipped on the straight. That's Subtome out into the dirt there as well. Gonzi just behind Blue Gobi. EDU battling with Jelly Ridges at the moment. There's Jim in the white. So we've got Oldsy for the surprise win from the YouTube comments. Oh, EDU and Jelly Ridges coming together there as well. EDU unfortunately come out worse of all that. I think he's going to lose a place to Jim here as well. There's a lot of paint training going on at the moment. So EDU's going to take the place back from Jim. Jim avoids any contact there as well. As the hold off, Lee W. Oh, it's whichever way you look, you can attack, but you're gonna have to defend as well. So bunched up at the moment. Jim on the attack here. Oh, this could be a great move. He does it. He's managed to find a way past EDU there as well. Great little move by Jim there. Saw the gap and then just pushed his way through. Awesome drive by Jim. So we've got Holtman still. Oh no, Holtman's in second. Cam has managed to take first place back. Some defense from Blue Gobi and he's got Gonzi just behind him there as well. Train of four cars for first at the moment. And we've got Jim just behind, a trail of cars there as well. There's absolute battles throughout the field at the moment. We'll try and get as much of the action as we can as possible. See Cam almost get on two wheels over the curbs. Gerald has just got Glazing just behind him there as well. EDU's dropped down to ninth. So newcomer to league as well. Second race of the season for MLB 197 running in 10th. He's got Lee W07. They used to had a little come together last week at Alton Park, so there'll be no love lost between these two tonight. I got Subtome there, who's just behind Lee W. Oh, I think is Subtome gonna make a move here? Very brave Subtome, what a great little move there by Subtome. Saw an opportunity, took it. But is Lee W gonna be able to get back on him here? Oh, Oh, sometimes managed to hold it. That was an awesome move going into the first corner there. Very, very brave, but when you know that you can do it, you can do it. Early W. Looked like he had to brake hard to avoid any incidents there as well. We've got Aldi down in 13th. Purple Twig, who's doing really well in qualifying, unfortunately. A couple of incidents at the start. Push that driver down to 14th. So, very close battle here between Lee W07 and Subtome. So, is Lee W going to be able to return the favour on corner one? You've got to have massive kahunas to pull a move off like Subtome and make it stick. Obviously, Subtome defensive there, holds his line. He's not going to let Lee make the same move on him. MLB right on the back of EDU Pro Driver now. I thought he was going to pull the dummy there. It's not. Might have been a little bit of lag that we've just got there. Takes a wide line into the corner. EDU able to just pull away just a little bit there as well. Catch up with the front of the field. So we've still got Cam leading. Holtman in second. Jim. A bit lonely out in fifth there as well. Generally just not too far behind. Can see how close it is here as well. Great battles for everyone though. At least no one is really driving too far out on their own. Oh, we've had one retirement. It looks like Scooby has had to retire. That's a real shame for him. But the action is still happening out on track. Oh, too wide there. MLB and Subtome through corner one. MLB not giving up that easy. Making Subtome fight position. Lee W getting nice sideways there through the corner. MLB might lose the place here, but he's going to have the line. Oh, and the cars connect. Go off. LB just losing one place out of that there. Everyone really pushing. Look at that. It's just no distance really between anyone. This track proving to be a great battleground for the Clio Cups. Subtome managed to get a little bit of breathing space between him and MLB now. He'll be able to just concentrate on attacking Lee W. Gonna look at making a move here. He gets through. Oh, but MLB straight back on it there. And into corner one we go. Oh, side by side again. Oh, Lee W getting his way through there as well. Got. So Purple Twig. Oh, lovely little two-wheel action there from Purple Twig. Subtome trying to hold on as long as he can. Breaking hard. Watch how the cars lean on the suspension. He's lost another place there, Purple Twig. Brilliant little move by Purple Twig there. MLB unfortunately can't do anything but concede. So Purple Twig now. Lee W to get past. Lee W is definitely not going to make it too easy for him. Oh, you'd think that he wouldn't. So Holtman's still in second. So Cam's still in first place. Jim's still in fifth as well. We'll stick with this at the moment. This close little battle for 10th place. Purple Twig managed to get a line there as well. So on board with Lee W07. Purple Twig gets a lovely run out of that corner. MLB. Unfortunately couldn't make enough ground just to get through. AW closed the door on him. Takes a wide line into the corner. There, just feathering the throttle. Oh, purple twig. Using huge amounts of the grass there as well, but no one capitalizing on it. Subtone locking up. Smoke screaming from the tires there. So, battle for third. Does see Gonzi. Look at this. Cam and Holtman. So Cam in the black and yellow, Holtman in the black and blue. On board with Holtman now. As close as you can be in these little cars. Oh, hard braking there. Has to brake to avoid any contact. That gravel not really looking like it's slowing people down as much as you'd think it would. So Cam pulling away a little bit there as well. Gonzi can sense that he can get in front, but it's just finding a way past. Can he do a move like Subtemi? He thinks about it, moves to the left. He's committed to it now. But Blue Gooby has managed to hold on to the place. Awesome driving there. Cameron Holtman side by side again. Literally, this track is so short that there's just no time to relax. It's just turn after turn after turn. And they've still got 18 minutes left, and the action has been absolutely non-stop at the moment. Nothing in it between first and second and third and fourth. Jim will be pushing hard to try and catch up. Subtone dropped down to 13th there as well, so he's obviously had a bit of a incident there as well. Oldie, unfortunately, not one of his best races today. He's dropped down to 14th. Oh, Subtone again. Looks like he's struggling with the car. Tyre wear, you know, you've been pushing. If you have a spin, the track being as it is going to kill those tyres. MLB trying to hold on here as well. So he's got Neckelman looking to make a move here. Subtome, who's looking to make a move on Neckelman. Sam will be doing really well here. Doing the best he can to hold them off. We're on board with Neckelman now though. Oh, unfortunately, if he got a bit of an exit out of that corner, could it be, might be able to capitalise here. He's definitely lost some ground there, MLB, from using the grass. I think he's done just enough though, just to keep out in front. Subtome seems to be quite good at taking this first corner, so might be able to see him close up a little bit. Oh, MLB kicks up some of the dirt there as well. Can only hope and pray that Neckerman doesn't have it in him to get past. Neckerman really pushing for it on this tight twisty German circuit. Absolutely brilliant circuit for these cars. We'll jump out to the front, see what's happening. Still, look at this between, Gonzi there, using the slipstream. But we've seen this before. He has now taken third. Both of them, little touch there, just letting know that they're side by side. But Gonzi has now done enough to get into third place. But can he hold on to it? And we've got Jim, who's slowly catching up. Still just over 14 minutes. Well, just under 15 minutes left of this race. The camera just catches up with everyone there. Take a little breather. So Gonzi is slightly pulling away. I don't know if we're going to see him catch up with the front two. See there, Jim in the background. Jim is definitely closing up ground. Reducing that gap of every corner. Well, at the moment, all eyes on Cam in the black and yellow and Holtman and the black and blue. On board with Holtman now, as he tries every can to get past. Cam played an awesome... Oh, Holtman thinks about it, but knew that probably wasn't going to get past doing that without making serious contact, so does the honourable thing and backs off. Yeah, that gravel doesn't look like it's slowing people down like it should do. Holtman's approached that corner looking much faster than Cam, so I think if Holtman could get out in front, I do think he could seriously pull away at certain times. You can see there the drag really helping Holtman down the straight. There's the gap, unfortunately, though. Cam on the nice defensive line. He's not going to let Holtman pass without a fight here. And now we can see the gap that Jim has managed to reduce. But is he going to be able to get past them? That is the big question. And is Holtman going to be able to get past Cam? This is such a tricky track to make any ground on, really. It's just so short. Pretty much the only time you have to breathe is the home straight. And it's not that long. And then it all starts over again. So just under 12 minutes to go, and Cam doing enough to keep his first spot. See there, Jim really making good ground here. So just look at the lap times. So where's Jim on 12.3, 12.2, Holtman, no, Gonzi with the fastest lap at the moment, just pretty much a 1.12. And Holtman just outside of that. So the FRT boys really pushing hard. So we see further back, the places have swapped again. And EDU, oh, he's had a nightmare tonight. He's dropped down to 13th. So Neckelman and Lee W fighting here. How close that is. Well held by Lee. He's not going to succumb to the pressure. Oh, Lee. Didn't look like there was any contact. Oh, Subtoe going in fast there. Looks like he, I don't know, eased off or something like that, but fortunately just went out wide across the grass. Didn't look like any contact. It might just be driver area. I might have jinxed it when I mentioned not succumbing to the pressure. So EDU, unfortunately, who's showed great potential over the last couple of weeks. Oscar Slurban has proved to be a difficult track for him. MLB really getting involved in the battles. And showing he has got great potential as well. Cam's still holding on to first place. He'll be looking at the timer. And I bet time feels like it's going very, very slowly for the lad. Look how close it is between them two. And Gonzi has managed to pull away slightly. And Jim has managed to close up. So Blue Gooby will unfortunately be looking at the distance timer increase for Gonzi and reduce for Jim. All Blue Doby could do is hope that he could hold on to this fourth place. So we're back with the front runners now. On board with Holtman. Oh, could. Oh, I thought Holtman might have been able to make a move there. Unfortunately, wasn't enough in it. Again, we're back on the home straight. Using the slipstream. Is he going to pull a dummy here? He's going to go right. Cam is not going to give in, though. Cam is going to hold his line. Well driven by Cam there. Did not succumb to it. Did not fall for it. Too experienced in this Clio Cup against these guys now to fall for that kind of trick. But Holtman trying every trick in the book here. And Cam just keeping his cool, holding his line. He's racing well. There we see Gonzi. Oh, and now we've got Jim, who is right up on Blue Gooby here. Of course, Cam's not going to know anything about this. He's just going to be concentrating on himself, but he needs Blue Gooby to hold off Jim, or ideally keep Jim where he is for the remainder of the race, just so he can close that points deficit as much as he can. Oh, Jim, unfortunately, thought he was going to make a move there. Looked like Blue Gooby might have caught him off. I don't know, there was a flash of lights there, maybe from Jim. I'm not too sure. It might be the lights. I don't know if Jim thought maybe he was cut off there by Blue Gooby. That will only just push Jim on, though. I'm sure he'll be speaking to the stewards if he feels that he was wrongly blocked right at the last minute. Unfortunately, I didn't get a clear look at it, so I can't really comment on it too much. But Jim did suddenly look like he had to lock up. Jim really pushing there, getting on two wheels. So we're on board with Jim now. He battles to get past Blue Gooby. I think we'll see him take a nice tight line riding the apex there. Lovely corner from Jim. I think we might see a change of position into the next lap from Jim here. He's definitely going for it. Late on the brakes, over the curb. Unfortunately, those curbs are very high on this track, and you do lose time by using them. Of course, makes the car very unstable there as well, but does well not to create any major incident from doing it. He knew what he was doing. Blue Gobi knew what he was coming as well, so both of them did well to keep to their own lines. And again, doing it here. Jim has got to have the line for the corner now as well. But Blue Gobi is out in front. Jim backs off. And he's got through. Blue Gobi, unfortunately, slight error there. Jim able to capitalise on it. But it's a huge gap now between him and Gonzi. There isn't a huge gap between Holtman and Cam, though. Holtman is going to push this until the very last second of the race. I think this is going to go right down to the wire. Hats off to Cam. He's done an amazing job of holding off Holtman tonight. Gonzi not a million miles away from this. We might see a three-way battle for first place come the end of the race. I mean, Holtman is going to see Gonzi getting bigger in his mirrors. He's going to have to think about defensive driving as well as attacking. It's very, very soon. Let's just see the fastest lap. So it is still Gonzi. I'm pretty sure that would have lap as well. I could be wrong. Holtman here. Going left, going right. And this has now allowed Gonzi to get right up on him. Gonzi's on fire at the moment. He is pushing. This is now earlier than what I thought, but a free car battle. I see Jim in the distance there. Not sure Jim has got enough to catch up. But now a difficult job for Holtman. It's not just about the car in front. It's the car behind as well now. Here we go. Oh, Gonzi. Oh, able to save it though. Does well, has not lost too much time from that. Down the home straight. Don't think Gonzi's going to be close enough to get anything from Holtman in terms of drag. Both the lights blaring there as well. Heavy braking into corner one. Holtman taking a very similar line to Cam this time. Oh, has he got a way past? There is contact. There is paint trading going on. Holtman's still in second, but not by much. Cam's got the inside line. Holtman's going to get... Holtman's now in first. Cam on two wheels, but Cam has now got the inside line again. Holtman out wide. Gonzi may be able to capitalise on this. Right up to each other. Holtman snaking left, snaking right. Does he attack? Does he defend? This is absolutely amazing Clio Cup action tonight. Hats off to Cam. Oh, again. Holtman getting his way through. But he's going out wide again. He's going to have the inside line for the first corner. I think Cam is going to have to take the wide line in. But sometimes that is the best line for this corner. You don't have to brake quite as hard for it. There we go. Cam manages, but Holtman still on the inside now. As contact. Gonzi is going to say thanks very much to the lads. I'm going to take a piece of this. Managed to get into second place now. This is an absolutely incredible battle for first. And I think this is going to be the final lap of the race as well. The timer is going to end before the finish line. So this is the battle for first. Hartman will be absolutely gutted. He's lost that second place, but absolutely nothing could do. Sensational drive by Gonzi to get to where he is at the moment. And can he find a way past Cam? All drivers using a bit of the dirt there as well. Gonzi out wide. Oh, Hartman out wide. I think Hartman's going to be able to get... Oh, there's a slight lock up there from Hartman. Gonzi goes through. Cam takes first. What an exceptional race tonight for Clio Cup. Each round getting better and better each week. Absolutely phenomenal drive by Cam. Superb. So Gonzi takes second. Holtman third. Jim fourth. Blue Goby fifth. Jellaridge is sixth. Purple Twig, well done. First race in. Does well to get 7th. Glazen, 8th. Nakama, 9th. So MLB 14th there. That was very, very intense battling going on throughout the race there as well. Fortunately, lap one on the start. Not sure what happened. Looked like Nakelman might have got turned by someone. Not really sure what happened. I'm sure there'll be chats going on within the group. Very intense racing by everyone. And great racing throughout the field tonight. But it's Cam that takes full I'm not sure why it says 12, mate. I was thinking that when you passed the line. Not sure what happened, but I mean, it's still out. It's still out on track. I'm not sure what's happened there, to be honest, mate. Again, it's not given us the option to save the replay, so unfortunately there won't be a highlight there. I don't think there's been a highlight video since race 3, but unfortunately it's not because I don't want to do it. The game is just not letting me save the replay, so I'm unable to do a highlight video. But this video will be up until I don't know. I don't think it's ever going to get taken down, to be honest. But it's exceptional racing. Again, we're back from 8:30 next Saturday for round 11 of the Ollie Pidgley Clio Cup. So do join us then, get involved, subscribe if you're new to the channel, and do, you know, share it around. And if you do want to get involved in sim racing, find us on Facebook, Next Gen Racing League's community, nextgenracingleague.co.uk. Add me on PSN, Robot Dancing Dad, and I'll catch you all soon. But thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you all next week.